Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to use customizable tables in Stata 17 to create a table from Stata commands. I'm going to be using the NHANES2L dataset, and you can open this by typing webuse NHANES2L. I'm going to begin by clicking Statistics here at the top, and then click Summaries, Tables, and Tests, and then select Tables of Frequencies, Summaries, and Command Results. This will open the table dialog box. So I'm going to begin by clicking on the Commands tab, and here I can create or add Stata command. So I'm going to click Create, and I'm going to type a command. In this case, a regression command, regress for BP systol is the dependent variable. And then I'm going to include age as a continuous variable and sex as a categorical variable, and then use the double hashtag here to fit a model that includes a main effect for age, a main effect for sex, as well as the interaction between them. So then I'm going to click Accept, and when I click Submit, I can see a draft of my table. So let's start modifying this a bit. Let's go back to the main tab, and under Columns here, I'm going to click the arrow and scroll near the bottom where it says Results. I'm going to select Result and click Submit. And now I can see that it's displaying the coefficient by default, and I'd like to customize this. So to customize my table, I'm going to come over here and click the Customize button at the bottom right, and this will open the Tables Builder. So the first thing I'm going to do to customize my table is I'm going to adjust the rows here. So here at the top where it says Rows, I'm going to click the little arrow next to Call Name, and then select Edit. And here I can select the rows that I want in my table. And so notice for the factor variables such as sex, it's displaying both the base level, sex equals male, that coefficient is zero, and the base level for the interaction is also male by age, and it's also zero. And I'd rather not display those. You can if you want, but I'm going to remove them. So I'm going to choose to display the constant or the intercept, as well as the two for two sex hashtag age, or that interaction just for the second term that includes female. And then 2.sex, which is the main effect for female here. And then I'm also going to check the box next to age. And when I click OK, now I can see that it's removed the base levels from the factor variables. And there's another way to do this as well, but that's a quick and easy way to do it also. The next thing I want to do is I want to add some more columns. So here where it says columns, I'm going to click the arrow next to result and click edit. And here I can add some more columns to my table. So notice I have result selected as the dimension here on the left, and for the levels, I'm going to select the coefficient, the standard error, the t-statistic, the p-value, and I can either select the confidence interval all as one thing, or I can select the upper and lower bounds separately, and I'm going to select them separately here. And there are lots of other things I could add if I want to, but I'm going to just leave it at that. So when I click OK, notice that I now have a table for coefficient, or the columns for coefficient, standard error, t-statistic, p-value, lower bound for the confidence interval, and the upper bound for the confidence interval. Okay, so now I'd like to do some more cleaning here. So the first thing I think I'll do is kind of tidy up the column headers here. So I'm going to click edit level labels here on the left, and then for the dimension, I'm going to select result. And I want to change four of the labels, coefficient, standard error, and you can't really see it anymore, but 95% lower bound and upper bound. So there are four things I want to change. So I'm going to select the dimension as result, and then I'm going to change four things. So I'm going to select the level RB, R underscore B. Its label is coefficient at the top of the column. And I'm going to shorten that to coef with just a dot. And then I'm going to select standard error underscore R underscore SE. And I want to shorten that just to SE. You can name these whatever you like. And then for the lower bound, I'm going to remove bound, so it just shows the 95% lower. And then for the upper bound, that level, I'm going to change the label to just 95% upper. Level is pulled from whatever the default is that you're using at the moment. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is just relabel those columns. So when I click OK, I can see that they've all been relabeled how I wanted. Now let's do some other things. Let's change the decimals for each of these columns. That's a lot of decimals. And so what I can do is go to Cell Appearance Styles. And here what I can do is I can change the various things for each column. So what I'm going to do is select some tags here. I'm going to check four of them because, again, I want to change COF, SE. Actually, I want five because I also want to change the T. Actually, I'll do the T statistic separately. So again, I want the dimension to be result, and the level is coefficient. And then I also want to adjust the result, which is the standard error. And I want to adjust result lower bound and result upper bound. And what I want to do is reformat those. I want to format those, the numeric format. So I'm going to click on the formats tab, and I can check all kinds of things here. I can change the border style for each of these, the font for each of these, shading, margins, and we'll see some of that here in a moment. But for now, I want to change the display, the numerical display format for these. So I'm going to change it to fixed numeric, and I want to display these with 3 decimal places of accuracy. So I'm going to click OK. And now I can see that those 4 columns now have 3 decimal places. I might also like to change the p-value to report 4, so I'm going to click Cell Appearance Styles again, and I'm going to select a new tag. This time I'm going to select Result and then the p-value, and again come over here to Formats, and I want to change it to fixed numeric, and I'm going to display that with 4 decimal places of accuracy. When I click OK, I can see that the p-value now has 4 decimal places. Okay. Some other things I might want to change. I can come over here to Cell Appearance Styles again. I'm going to click that. And I want to change some things for the entire table. So the first thing I'm going to change is the font. I'm going to change this to Arial. And I can click Submit to see that. So I've changed the font. I'd like to remove this vertical line here, and that vertical line is the right border of this first column. So I'm going to come over here to the Borders tab, and I'm going to select, check the box next to Separate Style for each side. And here for the right border, I can select the pattern as nil, and when I click Submit, that then removes that vertical line from the right side of the first column there. Now, another thing I might like to do is adjust the margins for each of these. My table is kind of compact, and I might want to add some space to that. So I'm going to click on Margins, and then here I want to select Separate Style for each side. And so for the top width, I'm going to type 5. For the right, I'm going to type 15. Bottom, I'm going to type 5. And left, I'm going to type 15. I only know this because I've played with it some. And when I click Submit, now I can see that it's added a little space. It's added some margins around the numbers and the labels and things, kind of spread it out, okay? So the last thing I might want to do, if this is how I want my table to look, I can then come over here and click Export, and I can export my table to a variety of formats. I can export it to a Word document, an HTML document, PDF file, Microsoft Excel file, LaTeX, SMCL, text file, or Markdown. And so I can save it and include it in my documents. So that's how you can use the customizable tables in Stata 17 to create tables from Stata commands. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.